make my own way. I will not surrender. I will do my best until I get put under.
Hello, my beautiful tubers. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you for tuning in. Today, I am actually going to be doing my first sickle cell chat with me vlog. So, it is the first ever Sickle Chat Thursday. I am so excited to be doing this on my channel. I don't know if you watched my previous sickle cell vlog. If you haven't, please check it out. Every Thursday from here on out, I am going to be posting a video, you know, talking about everything sickle cell, whether it's about myself or someone that I may know, medications, experiences that I've had in the hospitals, just everything regarding sickle cell, I will be talking and sharing with you guys. So I am so excited to be doing my first video for you guys today, and I hope you enjoy. So I was diagnosed at the age of 9, and I have sickle cell SS beta thalassemia, and you know, for the most part, I remember just being really tired when I was younger. I would always have to rest and sit down if I was doing like anything strenuous. I remember having pain. Now, I thought that this pain that I was experiencing, everybody felt that type of pain. So I didn't know that my type of pain was different and it was, you know, serious. I was very quiet. I never communicated how I felt, and I'm even like that up to now. I can't explain it, why I've always been this way, but it's just, you know, always been me. I would be really quiet. I wouldn't tell my parents or even my brothers. I wouldn't mention anything to them. So the year that I got diagnosed, I was so sick. I was in so much pain. I was really weak. I couldn't get out of bed. I couldn't eat. I couldn't do anything by myself. And that is when my parents took me to the doctor. As soon as the doctor saw me, he told them to take me to the ER right away. And when I went into the ER, I just remember being really scared. You know, that was my second time in the hospital, but this time was more severe and more scary, and especially from all the pain that I was feeling. And I just remember, you know, seeing all these doctors and all these nurses, and I was in a little small room with one little bed, and they had like these machines to the side and the IV pole. And I remember that they took my blood, and probably within 30 minutes the doctor came back. And that is when he then explained to my mom that I had sickle cell anemia. And I don't really remember too much after that. All I remember seeing was just units of blood hanging from the IV pole, and then they had to put a needle in my arm for the IV. And I just remember it being so painful, and I was crying from that as well. And once they gave me the medication, I was like in and out of sleep probably for like the first 4 days. Like, I don't remember anything from the first 4 days of being in the hospital. And the following day when I did wake up, I remember I was in a room. It was in the ICU unit. My mom was sitting at the end of my bed, and she just had like this really sad look on her face, and she then went on to tell me that I, you know, what I had, the severity of it, what we had to do from now on, how they were going to treat me in the hospital. Basically everything that the doctor had told her, she communicated that to me. And I do remember the nurses and doctors being so nice. Like, after the pain had gotten better and I started to feel like myself again, I wasn't scared. I was, you know, so comfortable being in the hospital, and it wasn't a traumatic experience for me. And then once I got out of the ICU, which I believe was on the 7th or 8th day, I can't remember, but I went into another room, and I was in a room with two other girls, and I just remember it being so fun. And to me, it was like a sleepover with these two new friends that I've made. And, you know, we just talk and laugh and have fun. So to me, it wasn't like I was in the hospital. I was just hanging out with these two new girls that I've met and just getting to know them and having fun. And it's not until they were discharged from the hospital that's like when it really hit me, like, oh wow, I'm still here. You know, when am I gonna go home? I started missing my brothers, I started missing my house, my friends at school. And, you know, I think that's when I started to feel a little sad. I did stay a week extra, and, you know, the doctors wanted to make sure that my levels were back to normal and that I was completely pain-free and I wasn't as weak and I was able to walk and stand on my own. And after that, when I got discharged and I went home, I remember the first day I went home, I had to take the subway home, and just being on the train and just seeing outside, I just remember feeling like so happy and so relieved to be out of the hospital. And I just remember on the train ride home, I was just taking in everything. I just was like appreciating, like, seeing the trees from, you know, the train, and just seeing the people. And I just remember just smiling at everyone. And, you know, at 9 years old, you know, I didn't know much about life, and I still didn't fully understand what had happened to me and what was going to happen in the future as well, and how my life was going to change from getting the diagnosis of sickle cell. But I just remember being so happy. And when I got home and I saw my brothers, and, you know, it was just a joyous, happy feeling. And to sleep in my own bed at night and to eat my mom's home cooked food, it was just really, really amazing. When I went back to school, it was so great seeing my friends. And, you know, a lot of my friends had wrote like get well cards, they drew pictures, and it was just so great to see them again. There was this one little mean boy though who was very mean to me, but he's not important. I'm not going to include him in this story. But, you know, I just remember just being so happy to be back in school and being with my friends and just, you know, just experiencing, you know, my life. And apart from that, growing up, you know, I would have pain. I would have to go to the hospital maybe once a year. And it was, you know, just a routine to me at that point. And I would go to the doctor, the hematologist, once a month. They would check my blood levels, ask me how I'm feeling, if I'm experiencing any pain. So it was basically the same checkup, you know, every month. And then when I would go to the hospital, it would be the same process of IV fluids, oxygen, pain medication. If I had an infection, I would get antibiotics. So as I got older and I started to learn more about what sickle cell was and how it was affecting my life, you know, I kind of educated myself to the best of my knowledge and from whatever my parents would tell me, and of course the doctors. And, you know, I didn't ever make it an excuse as to why I couldn't do something. I just remember being really happy. I never let sickle cell make me sad or depressed. And I was young, so I had like no recollection of ever, you know, being sad, apart from when I was sick and I would have to be in the hospital. That's probably the only time I would ever be sad. But for the most part, you know, I enjoyed my life, and my parents also made sure that I had a great life. They were a little bit more cautious with me, you know, compared to my brothers, but, you know, they treated me the same. They allowed me to do everything that I wanted to do. I didn't have like any limitations, except for I couldn't do anything strenuous. So probably around my teenage years, I started to experience more pain crises. Sometimes I was able to handle it at home, other times I would have to get admitted. And at this point, I was probably getting sick and having to be admitted to the hospital probably like every 8 months. And you know, I would spend maybe a week or two in the hospital. I was still very private and very quiet about when I would feel pain and when I wasn't feeling well. And I think that kind of did damage to myself because I would wait sometimes for days and not say anything. And at that point, the pain level would just be so high. My blood levels would drop and it just became more dangerous for myself. So as I got older, I started realizing that, and you know, I started to communicate more about how I was feeling. I'm still a little stubborn, I will admit. I'm still the same way, but I'm working on it, you know, as time goes on. So for the most part, my teenagers was great. I tried to be as normal as I could. When I would get sick, it would slow me down and hold me back from accomplishing certain things. But you know, I never let it stop me. You know, apart from being sick, sickle cell does have, you know, severe complications. I had my gallbladder removed, I had a stroke, I developed AVN, avascular necrosis, in my bones. I just wish everyone could understand the severity of how chronic our disease is and how painful it is. You know, we don't just suffer from pain, you know, physically. It affects us emotionally, mentally, and physically, and we just go through so much. And that is my main goal for creating this channel and for doing these vlogs for you guys, is to educate everyone. You know, I have sickle cell and I'm still learning every day more and more about my disease and how to manage and live with it. You know, we can have normal happy lives, and we do have normal happy lives. We just have a chronic illness that can sometimes slow us down, but it would never take over our lives and, you know, completely like just shut us down. And you know, a lot of people ask me, well, how does the pain feel from sickle cell, and you know, when I don't feel well? And the best way to describe it is, for me, I know everyone is different, but for me, the best way is I feel like someone is beating me with a hammer and they're just hitting every single bone and every single muscle in my body. Usually when I get pain, you know, my pain level would start like a 5 and then it would creep up. There has been on certain occasions where the pain would just come on just like that suddenly, and it would be a 10. And from all my worries out there, I know you guys have experienced this kind of pain where you would just get up or you would be doing something, laughing 1 minute, and you know, the pain just comes on just like that. And that, I would say, is the type of pain that I can't handle, that sudden sharp just everywhere pain from head to toe. That is the pain I cannot handle. You know, that is when I know I have to go to the hospital right away. Usually if it does start off slow, you know, like a 5, I can usually handle a 5, but anything above that is when I would have to take medications at home. And then when if it goes up to an 7 or an 8 and I'm still getting no relief at home, that is when I choose to go to the hospital. You know, I hate going to the hospital. It's one of, I don't like to say hate too much in life, but that is just one thing I hate. I hate going to the hospital. I do not like it whatsoever. You know, thankfully I haven't had too much bad experiences, you know, with doctors and nurses. You know, I hear other warrior stories on YouTube and it just breaks my heart to hear that you guys have to go through such horrible, you know, experiences. We've all been there. We've experienced it at least once or a couple times in our life, you know, from being in and out of the hospital. And it's just horrible. Like, we go to the hospital to get treated and to get better so we can come home to our loved ones. So when you have to go to the hospital and kind of you get treated like, you know, you are not human and you kind of get put down. And for me, I feel terrible for having sickle cell at that point, because it's like, okay, I'm coming to the hospital for you to treat me and for you to get me back on my feet again so I can go home to my family, but here you are not giving me the proper treatment and, you know, treating me as you should. So that is just one thing I wish that, you know, I can change, of how sickle cell warriors get treated when we go to the hospital. It's not right, it's not fair, and I just wish that they would come out for a certain treatment plan that every sickle cell patient, you know, gets, and everyone is treated fairly and right, and, you know, we don't get mistreatment from doctors and nurses. That is just a horrible thing to go through, and it just makes you feel so little as a person. It hurts you, it breaks your heart. Like, for the couple times I've had those experiences, you know, it just broke my heart, and I would cry. I would just feel so sad, and I would feel so little of a person. And I'm already a little person for all of those, you know, who know me in real life. Like, I'm such a little person. I'm 4'11", almost 5 feet. And, you know, to get just mistreated, it's not right. And I just want to change that about, you know, the medical community and the hospitals and the clinics and, you know, the urgent care centers. I just want to change how we get treated, you know, and for everyone to get treated fairly. Now, with medications, yes, we do have to take a lot of pain medications. You know, some of us choose to do the herbal way, some of us choose to do, you know, the traditional way of taking narcotics. I wish that one stereotype of sickle cell, you know, patients, that we are drug seekers, or, you know, we're just going to the hospital and faking being sick because we want to get high off of pain medication. Like, if you guys just knew how terrible and excruciating the pain was, like, you would understand. And like I said, the best way to explain the pain is I just feel like someone is beating me with a hammer. When it's that sharp, excruciating pain, like all over my body, I feel like someone is taking an ice pick and just every single inch of my body, it's getting beaten with that ice pick. You know, I'm so blessed that I am married now. I have two beautiful kids, two beautiful, amazing boys, Liam and Caden. You know, I will talk about them a lot more in my future videos. And for all my sickle cell mommies out there, I will tell everyone, even non-sicklers, I usually try to explain like how bad the pain is. And I would take labor pain and contractions and just pain from having a baby any day over a sickle cell crisis. And that's just to give you guys more of a picture of how severe the pain is. For those of you, you know, who don't have sickle cell, you may know someone that has sickle cell, or you may just want to educate yourself about this disease. You know, please, please, please read up about sickle cell. Just get educated. And, you know, if you know someone with sickle cell, when they're sick, just be there for them and just support them, because it's such a horrible feeling to go through a, you know, a pain crisis or having complications from, you know, sickle cell, like other complications. It's just a horrible feeling not having anyone there. I'm so glad I joined YouTube, because I have made so many sickle cell warrior friends, and it's just nice that I can finally have people that can relate and know exactly what I go through. You know, prior to joining YouTube, I only know two girls, and I've met them in the hospital, and they also have sickle cell, and, you know, they both have kids. So it's such a great feeling to have someone, and, you know, to actually be in my shoes. You know, my friends and family, they're always there for me, but they don't know the severity and of how I feel and what I go through. So it's nice to have people that, you know, fully understand every aspect of what we go through, and it's just amazing. And I am so glad I joined YouTube. I just want my voice to be heard. And you know, my voice may be small and little and soft-spoken, but you know, my message is strong and powerful and loud, and I just want to get that message out there to my mom and dad. I know you guys always watch my vlogs. I just want to say thank you so much, you know, for always being there for me. I'm so sorry I'm getting emotional, but you know, just talking about what I go through and you know what I've been through in my life, it just makes me sad and happy at the same time. So it's bittersweet. These are bittersweet tears. But to my parents, I just want to say thank you so much for always being there for me and always being so supportive and you know, just taking such good care of me. And to my amazing husband, you know, you're the one who has always been by my side, you know, from back when we were friends up until now through our marriage. You know, we've been through so much ups and downs in our marriage from sickle cell, and I just want to say thank you so much, and I love you so much. And to my beautiful boys, I hope I live to 110 to be around to watch you guys just grow up into beautiful young men. And you know, I just love you guys so much. And you know, this is my story with sickle cell. I will have future videos for you guys every Thursday. Please tune in. I promise I will have a video every Thursday for you guys. Thank you for tuning in for my very first Sickle Chat Thursday. I had such a great time talking about my illness and just spreading the word to you guys. And to all my warriors out there, I hope you guys are well. I hope you are pain-free. If you are in the hospital, I hope you get to go home soon and you recover fast. And you know, just hang on and just know that God is by your side. And I will have you in my prayers and hope that you get to go home soon to your loved ones. So I love you guys so much. I will see you in my next video. Bye.